there's been a heartbeat of people in Nigeria. That heartbeat is asking one question. When can our nation, Nigeria, wear the colors of greatness that nature endowed her with? That trend is that 20 years ago was better than 10 years ago. 10 years ago was better than 5 years ago. 5 years ago was better than 2 years ago. 2 years ago was better than today. And I ask, how did we get here? We're saying it is time to heal our history for a new beginning. Thank you for coming. Welcome to Abuja, and welcome to the new Nigeria.
You know, we sent out this call through social media and all of that stuff. Many people saw it, they ignored it. Some of them abused us. You know, Sheikh Obanka, you know, who are you? This country is going to disintegrate. Why are you wasting your time? I mean, the kind of insults we got, seeing you here, the pain of the insult is gone, right? Because we know together we can make history. So once again, you're all warmly welcome. And we've taken note of your expectations. And we are going to share with you our own objectives for hosting this summit. In the New Nigeria is Possible group, we have a driving force. And what's that driving force? All things are possible. Because when I tell you what our objectives are, your first thought will be, you're joking, it can't happen. That's why I'm preparing your mind for saying, all things are what? Possible. That shows us that when you set your mind to do something, it will come to pass. Even though other people are saying it will never happen. So, all things are possible when you take the time to think about it seriously. We are here not to cast accusations upon somebody. We are here not for recriminations. We are here not to fight. We are here not for vengeance. But we are here because we realize that we have faulted Nigeria and faulted one another in one way or the other. And in that way, I'm here to apologize to you and tell you I am sorry. And guess what? You also tell me what? I'm sorry I've also defaulted you. I want that to be very clear in our hearts. So please, we're not here to fight one another. If this was a government-organized program, right? There'll be all kinds of wahala. But see, government is not involved in this. Like Chris said, this is what? Weapon. We, the people of Nigeria. Nigeria is one great family, and over the years, we have offended one another in one way or the other. And we're here to say sorry so that we can restore our relationship, heal our past, and then move on as one big, powerful entity that is literally unstoppable. So these are the imperatives we must embrace. The reason why we're doing what many people say is impossible is because we understand this principle. In psychology, it's called the power of representative action and responsibility. Nature abhors a vacuum. And there are certain basic expectations that nature has, that providence has, that people should live a good life. You know, people should have wonderful things happen. But when it's not happening, and the people that are supposed to make that thing to happen are not doing it, nature gives you the right to step up to the plate and do for the good of the bigger society what those who are supposed to do are not doing. So that's why we're doing what we're doing. We know what will happen to the whole of Nigeria by the time we conclude what we're going to do here tomorrow. Nigeria will never be the same again because of the power of representative action and responsibility. That tiny amount of yeast, what does it do to the rest of the dough? It affects it. So we are the yeasts. We are the yeasts. that's going to affect what? The whole of Nigeria. We are here to make history. We are here to do what has never been done before. We are here to do what they say cannot happen. And by the end of this summit, Nigeria will be healed. Nigeria will be reconciled. All the cleavages, the divisions will be wiped away. And Nigeria will be one big family once again.